तुझको या तेरे नदीश गिरिवन को नमन करूं मैं, किसको नमन करूं मैं भारत, किसको नमन करूं मैं, नमन करूं मैं, नमन करूं मैं, नमन करूं।
Just as the popular principle of Ayurveda that no vegetation of the world is without purpose and that there is definitely one or the other medicinal property in them. Similarly, the scientific world also believes that there is some definite usage of everything in the world. It is possible to generate energy from the dirtiest of dirty things in the world. To make this contention a reality, scientists have started generating electricity from different types of waste by developing special techniques. With the help of waste, for which everyone has hatred, has become an important economic source by being transforming into energy. It is the moral responsibility of every municipal corporation to install 3 different garbage bins at different places in their city. One could be for only wet waste from the kitchen, the another one for plastic, glass, metals, and such other items which can be made use of by recycling. The third one should be for the other types of waste from which energy can be generated by burning it to ashes. The first type of waste can be used to generate biogas. To keep the country clean, it is a responsibility of every citizen to cooperate in this endeavor. In the city of Munich in Germany, more than 10% of the total energy generated is obtained by burning the waste matter. In this context, in India, about 16 megawatt of electricity is generated every day from 1300 tons of waste matter in Okhla at Delhi. If enlightened awareness gets kindled in the people of the country, 3600 megawatts of electricity can be generated from waste matter.
There can be 2 ways of handling dry waste. One is to generate energy by burning it to ashes at 1000 degrees Celsius. The other is to burn it slowly through the landfill gas recovery process to produce methane from which energy can be generated. The remnant matter can be converted to fuel oil by the process of pyrolysis and gasification. The harmful radioactive waste can be converted to energy through the process of plasma arc technique.
Natural gas can be converted to methanol and petrol. Similarly, carbon dioxide can be converted to calcium carbonate and sulfur dioxide into gypsum. It is also the moral responsibility of people living in villages not to throw their household waste on the roads or in the pond, lake or river. They should dig a pit either in their compound or in their agricultural field and keep dropping their waste along with cow dung. By this, they would be able to generate compost as well as keep their environment clean.
The nature has provided some such trees in the form of gift, with the help of which the earth can be cleansed of poisonous metals. The fern plants can remove arsenic. The Brahmi tree, apart from improving memory power, has also the special property of removing lead, mercury, cadmium, and chromium from the soil. The mustard plant can also remove cadmium, lead, selenium, zinc, and copper. Same way, the cottonwood tree can remove the pollution of carcinogenic carbon tetrachloride and such carbonic pollutants by almost 95%. Even the sunflower plants have the ability of removing lead and zinc.
So far, water hyacinth that are found in ponds was considered as a weed waste, but its importance that has come to awareness is that it can purify water by removing the toxic metals like cadmium and mercury. If that can be put to use in a well-planned way, they can provide good fertilizers in the form of 33 kg of potassium, 22 kg of calcium, and 3 kg of magnesium per hectare every day. It is the principle of nature that everything in this world has both good and bad qualities, either in lower or higher proportion. Even the plastic is not an exemption from this point of view. Because of being lighter and corrosion preventive, it is used in the making of airplanes, computers, and other electronic items. By the usage of these in different types of applications, it helps save money and energy. Usage of plastic bags and sacks instead of paper bags and jute sacks no doubt brings about greater monetary savings. Due to this, the plastic empire has grown so big that today the world uses nearly 1,500,000,000 tons of plastic, which is on the increase every day. Every minute, people in the world purchase 1 million plastic bottles of drinking water, and 50 billion plastic bags are used every year.
56 lakh tons of plastic waste originate every year in India. Of the 9,205 tons of waste generated every day in the country, 6,137 tons of plastic waste, which persists in the soil, rivers, canals, and mountains, cause great environmental pollution. While Delhi alone generates 690 tons of plastic waste every day, Chennai generates 429 tons, Kolkata generates 426 tons, and Mumbai 408 tons. Plastic waste is floating on the surface of about 50 lakh square miles of all the oceans of the world. Presently, 1500 lakh tons of plastic waste has accumulated in the world, which is causing great harm to the environment. Till 2004, 20 lakh tons of plastic waste got generated because of the 3,150 lakh computers becoming useless.
Keeping in mind the economic profit, companies have started manufacturing disposable plastic bottles and bags by adopting the policy of use and throw. Items like plastic watches, razor, pen, and other such are manufactured which are usable only for short time. This irrational policy is posing great danger to environment. Milk, water, cold drinks, and other eatable items are stored in plastic bottles and cans. In course of time, bisphenol starts leaching out of the plastic containers and through the consumable items, it enters into our body and causes or gives rise to diseases like cancer and heart ailments.
The poisonous chemicals of the plastic waste accumulated by mixing with rainwater is also polluting the aquifers. The cows searching for food in the waste consume the plastic containers also along with the food items, becoming the cause for their untimely death.
The plastic bags and such waste pose destruction to the sewage system of the cities. They also impede the flow of water in canals and ultimately give rise to many diseases. Plastic is neither biodegradable nor chemically degradable, and so it persists in the environment for thousands of years and serves as a great environmental pollutant. When burnt, it gives rise to poisonous gases like hydrogen cyanide and dioxin, which after entering through the respiratory tract of animals and humans can become a cause of dangerous diseases like cancer. Through rivers, plastic enters into the sea and becomes the cause of the death of marine animals like turtles, whales, seals, and such other fishes, as well as seabirds. As per the reports, about 1 lakh marine mammals and 10 lakh of seabirds are recorded to die due to consumption of plastic.
The people who believe in money alone as the source of eternal happiness take shelter under the false argument that the plastic is essentially useful because it is cheap, durable, energy saver, and corrosionless. Are they not becoming the victims of daydream by taking the above contention as truthful? Many other materials can also be durable and corrosion-free. But is it right to impose it on the world just because it is cheaper, and that too when everyone knows that it is an enemy of environment and is the cause of many deadly diseases like cancer, heart disorder, and other such diseases? Is it that money alone is important to people with such thought process? Can't they see that the plastic is the cause of the death of many marine organisms and cows?
Are they not able to hear the painful and distressful cries of dumb animals and humans suffering from cancer? Do they not have even a little bit of sympathy in their hearts that they can tell others about the harmful effects of plastic by seeing the pain of those who are dying? Have they also forgotten the statement of the Supreme Court that we are sitting on a plastic bomb? Did not people drink water or carry around things or use furniture, etc., when there were no plastic bottles, bags, or furniture? When America alone throwing 60 million plastic per day or 22 billion in a year, it is now easy to think that how much plastic waste is thrown by our world of 17 billion population and the impact of environmental pollution. Can we not use bottles or vessels of copper, brass, steel, glass, or clay instead of plastic bottles while traveling? Animals like cows, fishes, and turtles, which eat plastic accidentally in their search for food to satisfy their hunger, die because of interference in their respiration. Do not our hearts get distressed and distraught by seeing such painful deaths of animals? Are we so stone-hearted?
by being sentimental about the sentiment of
sarvabhutanam hite ratah.
Can't we use bags made of paper, jute, calico and starch instead of bags made up of plastic? Don't we have even a bit of sympathy in our hearts for the creatures that meet with untimely death? Even after knowing the bitter truth that those creatures which die cannot be brought back to life, why are we continuing to use plastic bags and bottles? Is it that money is more important for us than the lives of these creatures?
No doubt, plastic bottles are harmful to our health, but the chemical that is added to preserve the water for longer time is at times more in concentration. In such cases, continuous consumption of water from such bottles is always very dangerous to health. In restaurants and on occasions like marriage and religious celebrations, plates, cups and glasses made of melamine, plastic and thin thermocol material are in common use. While hot foods and drinks are served in this, the poisonous chemicals in them leach out and get mixed with food, becoming the cause for painful diseases like cancer.
There are two types of plastics, thermoplastic and thermosetting. Of these two, only thermoplastic is recyclable. Of the plastic waste that pollutes the environment, about 20% is thermoplastic. The Toshiba company of Japan has developed the technology of extracting fuel oil from thermoplastic. This technique plays a special role in preventing the thermoplastic-based environmental pollution.
It is a moral responsibility of all people to completely forgo the use of plastic bottles and bags and also minimize the usage of other items made of plastic. This only can contribute to the well-being of all. Aluminium is a poisonous metal. Being cheaper, it is used to make vessels for cooking and eating, but people are ignorant of the harmful effects of it. Cooking food in aluminium vessels can lead to diseases related to brain like Alzheimer's, Parkinson's, dementia, etc., which are very difficult to cure.
Even the non-stick vessels are harmful from the health point of view. The necessity of the time is that our society should return back to the usage of vessels made of iron, copper and brass and earthen pots. Cooking food in the earthen pots is very superior.
In present time, extensive use of chemical fertilizers and pesticides is being made for improved crop yield and to protect the crops from pests. Such chemicals like DDT, aldrin, heptachlor and andrin are all highly poisonous, and continuous use of them results in the development of resistance in insects and pests, which in turn necessitates the use of higher doses of these chemicals,
and this causes
much higher damage to the environment. These insecticides, pesticides and fertilizers not only make the environment toxic by getting mixed with soil, water and air, but also invite dangerous diseases like cancer in humans by entering the body through food.
It is necessary that we should use vermicompost, compost and green fertilizers instead of chemical ones to save ourselves from cancer and kidney diseases. we should also explore the possibility of such chemicals that can be developed from cow urine and insecticide plants like neem, which can keep our crops safe from pests instead of chemical insecticides and pesticides.
No doubt, people get attracted by seeing the ripe fruits in the market like mangoes, bananas and papayas. But very few people are aware of the fact that they are ripened by using poisonous chemicals like calcium carbide, aldrin, etc., which are the cause for many diseases including cancer.
Fruits like bananas and others can be ripened by using cardamom, starch and activated carbon. However, in the greed for earning money, fruit sellers use such deadly chemicals like calcium carbide and aldrin to ripen fruits. Such people are definitely the enemies of mankind, and they force us to eat poison in the garb of fruits. Even the health and sanitization officers are also guilty because they overlook the crimes of such merchants by taking bribe.
Calcium carbide is a harmful chemical which is used in generation of ethanol gas. Even though they help ripen fruits faster, some part of it gets into the fruits, which is difficult to be removed even after washing. The consumption of such fruits can lead to increased possibilities of heart ailments, burning sensation in stomach and chest, ulceration in the throat, bloody diarrhea, brain disorders, and cancer.
Today, there is a need for mass awakening to prevent the adulteration of fruits, vegetables and milk, and also save innocent, gullible people from becoming victims of premature death. Till such time, the whirlwind of selfishness persists, there is no scope for solution to this problem.
The electromagnetic radiation emitted by electric wires and electronic items creates an invisible cover in the surrounding areas known as electrosmog, has dangerous impact on animals and humans. There is possibility of development of cancer in people living near the high-tension power lines. The radiation coming out of such high-tension wires is quite dangerous and can become the cause of many diseases.
It is more or less the opinion of all scientists that the extensive use of mobile phones can cause great damage to human brain. The electromagnetic radiation emanating from the cellular phone harms medulla oblongata, the most important part of the brain. This radiation of mobile phones is also very harmful to the people who have implanted artificial pacemakers in their hearts. Such patients should also keep away from the places where walkie-talkies are being used. To remain safe from the harmful effects of cell phone radiation, one should make use of hands-free or earphones.
The rays emanating from the computer monitors can harm the cornea of people spending long hours in front of the computers. Such people should be advised to use protective shields while spending long hours in front of computers. It is also advisable to erect telephone and mobile towers and construction of power stations away from the dwelling places of people. Cooking food in microwave ovens is also dangerous, as the microwave radiation emitted by it can cause damage to the tissues of the eyes, skin, and muscles. Excess exposure to microwave radiation can lead to increasing incidence of cancer, heart ailments, and blood-related disorders.
Unnecessary exposure to X-rays and CT scans should be avoided because they are a cause for cancer. It is the opinion of eminent scientists that the electromagnetic field that develops near the high-tension power lines can interfere with the movement of the ions within our body cells. As a consequence, this can give rise to diseases like heart ailments, cancer, memory loss, and such others. 15 to 20% of children in America living near high-tension power lines have been reported to suffer from cancer. In such a situation, it is necessary that one should live at least 60 meters away from such high-tension power lines.
Nearly about 300 nuclear power plants are in operation in the world. The radioactive emissions from such plants are playing a dangerous role in spreading pollution. The radiothermal waste is very harmful from the environmental point of view. Radium, thorium, and plutonium, which are present in the radioactive waste, are very poisonous and are the cause of cancer and other diseases. The harmful effects of these persist in the environment for a long time, such as radium for 32,000 years, plutonium for 5 lakh years, and thorium for many lakhs of years. Like a volcano, the radioactive explosions are deadly for all animals and humans. The incident of radioactive leakage that occurred from the Chernobyl power plant on April 26, 1986, not only affected Russia, but also the Poland, Denmark, Sweden, Norway, etc. Nearly 5,76,000 people of these countries became victims of thyroid, cancer, leukemia, etc. due to exposure to the radioactive rays.
In the modern materialistic time, the problem of noise pollution is on the increase. The horns blown by the fast-moving vehicles on the roads, the supersonic airplanes, trains, industries, the blaring loudspeakers at religious places, and the loud-sounding bands and musical systems all contribute to uncontrolled generation of noise pollution. Due to exposure to high noise pollution, people can become deaf. The behavior of such people becomes irritable and prone to bouts of anger. The noise pollution can also contribute to increased heart rates, cholesterol level, and mental stress. Even their digestive functions get affected.
People who have interest in spiritual acts like meditation, devotion, self-study, and research would naturally prefer to stay in isolation, away from the cacophonic world of hustle and bustle. There is no moral right for anyone to produce high-sounding noise either through loudspeakers or by blaring horns, or contribute to increasing noise pollution by any other means. Giving respect to the sentiments and rights of others, we should endeavor to keep the environment as quiet and peaceful as possible. Higher density of trees can help us in this greatly, as they have the ability of dulling the intensity of sound.
The polluted minds of humans alone are at the root of all pollution-related environmental effects. The blemish activities related to lust, anger, greed, desire, ego, and craving all contribute to gradual deterioration of the environment. People who become contented and happy by cutting off trees, killing off innocent animals for lingual pleasure and cosmetic beautification, provoke wars to demonstrate one's power, taking the help of terrorism to impose on others one's language and religious belief, throwing industrial effluents into the rivers and domestic waste on the roads are all demonstration of mental pollution.
The Indian culture makes a proclamation, Vasudhev Kutumbakam, meaning the entire world is my family. This sentiment, by cutting across the boundaries of sects, regions, classes and nations, plays on the chords of lute of universal brotherhood. It inspires the entire world to walk on the sacred path of live and let live. What is the mentality of the Western culture which gives into the concept of thinking for the welfare of only self, when many people of Asia and Africa are dying of hunger? They are feeding cattle with grains just to fatten them to meet their lingual pleasures for meaty food.
If the world would accept the contention of Yajurved,
Yastu sarvani bhutani atmanaivanu pashyati sarva bhuteshu chatmanam tato na vichikichati tato na vichikichati tato na vichikichati.
According to which one sees oneself in every creature, meaning seeing one's own consciousness in all, will never pollute the environment in the pursuit of monetary benefits, because one will realize that due to one's activities, other creatures can be harmed. This can become possible only when the minds of all have the desire of well-being of all. The Veda has given an instruction to all mankind that
Me manah shiv sankalp mastu,
meaning I may tread the golden path of mental determination for the well-being of all. The Veda has expressed such enchanting desire for environment in the cause of whole world.
Shanno vatah pavatam shanna tapatu suryah shannah kanikrata devah parjanyo avivarshatu.
May the air flow to bring peace. May the sun shine to bring peace to us. May the thundering clouds, endowed with divine qualities, rain to bring peace to all. The entire creation has manifested from that one and only one Supreme Lord. In this scenario, it is the responsibility of all to be proactive towards the preservation of the environment with the sentiment of the welfare of the whole world by rising above the differences of faiths, language, appearance, color, and the boundaries of the nations.
What eminent a message has been given to the whole world by the Tartamani of Sri Prannath ji.
Prem pyala भर भर पियो त्रैलोकी छाक छकाऊं चौदे भवन में करूं जाला फोर ब्रह्मांड पियो पासे जाऊं पासे जाऊं।
We have to assimilate the contentions of the Ved for pure and clean environment and world peace.
Om Sangachadvam Samvadadvam Samvo Manansi Janatam Deva Bhagam Yatha Purve Sanjana Namupasate.
Let's all walk together. Let's talk to each other with love. Let there be similar thoughts in all our minds. Just as the past seers had venerated the Supreme Lord, let us all also do the same way.
Samani vakutihi samana hidayani vah samanamastu o mano yatha vah Susahasati.
May the resolve of all be the same. May the hearts of all be alike. May the minds of all be alike, so that the aim of great deed be certainly accomplished. With the highest sentiment of Sukh Sheetal Karun Sansar, let us all make an auspicious wish for the welfare of the entire mankind and the environment.
सर्वे भवन्तु सुखिनः सर्वे सन्तु निरामया सर्वे भवन्तु सुखिनः सर्वे सन्तु निरामया सर्वे भवन्तु सुखिनः सर्वे सन्तु निरामया सर्वे भवन्तु सुखिना सर्वे सन्तु निरामया सर्वे भद्राणि पश्यन्तु मा कश्चित् दुःखभाग् भवेत् मा कश्चित् दुःखभाग् भवेत् मा कश्चित् दुःखभाग् भवेत् ॐ शान्ति शान्ति शान्ति